Hi, I'm Martin Ingram. I'm VP of Strategy with AppSense. And today I want to discuss delivering client computing from the cloud. There's been plenty of discussion about how we can move data center components into the cloud and how we can build customer-facing websites that are served by cloud providers. But there's an opportunity to move client computing into the cloud as well. Now, that brings us into some interesting opportunities. But the objective here isn't to move a desktop image and purely host it in the cloud, because at that point we're then restricted in terms of where we buy services from. Everything comes from a single cloud provider for the users we serve in that way. And that's a model that can work, but it's not really cloud because we don't have that agility and the flexibility we'd expect. It's really closer to outsourcing. And there's nothing wrong with outsourcing, it's just it doesn't give us that flexibility and the ability to move between providers. The reality is that for cloud to really work as a client computing technology, we need to be able to buy services from different vendors and have them integrate together seamlessly for our users. So for instance, we might choose to buy our email service from this provider here. We might choose to buy our office products from a second provider, say over here. But we still want that the user can double click on an attachment in an email provided by this service provider and have it open in an office application provided by a completely separate service provider. Now, in the case of a traditional desktop, that just kind of works because everything runs in one place. To make that work in the cloud will require integration between those cloud providers. And that's one of the focus areas that you'll see AppSense working on in the future, to be able to bring those separate solutions together, those separate service providers solutions together, so that you get a solution for your users that works transparently for them. Thank you for your time today, and look out for more news from AppSense over the coming weeks.